Hello, welcome to another GoJS Intermediate tutorial. This video will explain and demonstrate how to use ports, which allow for link connections between nodes at precise points. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. Additionally, this video assumes you understand the basics of GoJS, which are covered in the GoJS Beginner Videos series. This video will explain how to define and customize ports for your nodes. Even without ports, you have some control over where links connect at a node, at a particular spot, along one or more sides, or at the intersection with the edge. However, there may be times you want a more specific graphical place on a node where links should connect. These elements are called ports. There may be any number of ports on a node. By default, there is one port, the whole node. This results in the effect of having the whole node act as the port. This is the same behavior you have seen in any previous videos or samples that use links with nodes. To declare an element in a node a port, set the graphobject.portid property to a string value. Port or link-related properties may be applied to any element in the visual tree of a node, which is why they are properties of graphobject and not node. Ports may only exist on nodes and groups, not links, adornments, or simple parts. Let's start with a single port example. In some situations, you may want links to connect to some element of a node, but you don't want those links to connect to the whole node. In this case, each node has only one port, but you do not want the whole node to act as that single port. Let's use this node template and this model data. You can declare any graph object to act as a port by setting its portID property. Note that we did not set this property yet, so the whole node will be treated as the port. When we load the page, we can see this clearly. In this case, we've set the graphobject.fromSpot and toSpot properties of the node, so links connect to the left and connect from the right. Since the height of the whole node includes the text label, the middle of the side of a node is not the middle of the shape element, the green circle. Perhaps we do not want this appearance. Let's say we want the links to connect to and from the green circle, not the whole node. If we want a single particular element to act as the port rather than the whole node, set its graphobject.portid property. In this case, we'll use the empty string. The empty string is the name of the default port. So in this example, we'll set the portid property for the shape element of the node. We must also move any other port-related properties, such as the fromSpot and toSpot properties, from the node's properties object to the shape element's properties object. Now, if we reload the page, the links connect to the ellipse shapes. It's common to want more than one port in a node. You may want a varying number of ports for your nodes. We must have some way for link data to know which port the link should come from or connect to. Normally, a graph links model assumes there is no need to recognize port information on link data. To support port identifiers on link data, you need to set graphLinksModel.linkToPortID property and graphLinksModel.linkFromPortID property to be the names of the link data properties. For this reason, if you need to set the graphObject.portID property on any element to be a non-empty string, you must use a graphLinks model and set these properties. Then set these properties on your link data. Let's demonstrate this. First, let's change our node template so it has two shape elements acting as ports, one on the left of the main node shape and one on the right. Notice how each of these ports has a distinct port ID property value. To be able to use the port ID property values inside link data, we must set the graphLinksModel.linkToPortID property and graphLinksModel.linkFromPortID property. Let's set these to toPort and fromPort respectively. Then, all we must do is update the data in the link data array to include these properties. We'll make this link come from the alpha node's R going to the beta node's L port. Now, reload the page. We see our nodes are connected by a link from the right port of the alpha node to the left port of the beta node. This is because we specified the toPort and fromPort properties for the link data. Remember, those properties themselves were defined as the values of the graphLinksModel.linkToPortID property and graphLinksModel.linkFromPortID property. Setting the graphObject.fromLinkable and graphObject.toLinkable properties to true allows users to interactively draw new links between ports. Let's set both these properties to true for both of our node templates ports. Let's comment out our entry in the link data array for now. reload the page, then click on a port and drag. We see now we can create a new link from one port to another. By default, the user may not draw more than one link in the same direction between any pair of ports, nor may the user draw a link connecting a node with itself. If we want to allow multiple links to or from ports, we can set the from linkable duplicates and to linkable duplicates properties. These properties govern whether or not a user may draw multiple links to or from this port. Let's set the from linkable duplicates property for our pink port to true, and the to linkable duplicates property for our green port to true. Reload the page. We see now we can create multiple links from pink ports, and multiple links may go into green ports. We can also allow links to attach to ports on the same node they come from by setting the from linkable self node and to linkable self node properties to true. Let's do this for both our ports, then reload the page. We can now create links from a port on a node that connect back to a port on that same node. That's it for this video. To learn more, visit the intro page on ports. Head over to gojs.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.